Good morning, students. How are you? I hope you all are doing well and enjoying good food with your family. So, students, I am back again with next video. Let's continue with the chapter Too Big and Too Small. Yesterday, we had read about Shanu and her confusion about too big and too small. She was continuously thinking, is she big or is she small? So, students, first of all, I want to show some pictures. As you know, yesterday we talked about baby's coat and stove. So, let me show the pictures of baby's coat and stove. So, you can see in these pictures, small babies sleep in the swing, or should I say palna in Hindi. And the next picture is of stove, where your mom cooks food. Now, students, let's continue with the reading. What am I the right size for? Shanu wonders. Ammi smiles and says, you are just big enough to go to school. And you are just small enough for me to carry you on my shoulders, says Abbu. You are just big enough to take me for my morning walks, says Dadu. And you are just small enough for me to tell stories too, says Dadi. And you will be always be the perfect size for this, they all say, and give her a warm, wonderful hug. So, students, now Shanu is thinking, what am I right size for? Some of my family members says I am too big, and some says I am too small. Then who am I? Am I small or am I big? So she is thinking, in which thing I will be fit? So I explain you. What am I the right size for? Shanu wonders. Here Shanu is continuously thinking, what am I for? In the next line, Ammi smiles and says, you are just big enough to go to school. So, students, what is Ammi saying here? Ammi smiles and says, Peta, you are that big that you can go to school. That means now you are big enough to go to school. That means you are able to sit in the class. You are able to understand things. You are able to walk. You are able to write. So basically, Ammi is saying you are big. In the next line, you are just small form enough for me to carry you on my shoulders, says Abbu. So, students, what is Abbu saying here? Abbu is saying that means, first of all, Abbu means her father. Okay? Who is Abbu? Abbu is Shanu's father. So, what is her father saying? Her father is saying, you are small enough for me that I can carry you on my shoulders and I can lift you up on my shoulders. We can walk both together on my shoulders. So I hope you all are trying to getting my point. So at some places, Shanu is big. Shanu is big enough to go to school. Hana? And what is your Abbu saying? That you are small enough to enough for me to carry you on my shoulders. So the next line. You are just big enough to take me for my morning walks, says Dadu. Who is Dadu? Dadu is Shanu's grandfather. So what is her grandfather saying? Her grandfather saying, you are big enough for me and we can both go on morning walk. So why we both can go on walk? So what is her father replying? Grandfather is saying, because you are big enough to walk properly. Next line. And you are just small enough for me to tell stories too, says Dadi. So students, who is Dadi here? Shanu's grandmother. So what is her grandmother saying? She is saying that you are not big enough that I can't tell you stories. You are small enough for me so I can tell you bedtime stories. Now tell me, students. I'm asking you one question and give me a proper answer. So, when you were small, have ever your grandparents told you any story? I know. Of course, yes. When I was kid enough, my grandparents also used to tell me lot of stories. So, obviously, your grandparents also tell you. As I know, some of the grandparents tell their grandchildren stories right now also, because our grandparents love their children a lot. Now, next line. And you will always, always be the perfect size for this. They all say, give her a warm, wonderful hug. Now, what they all are saying here. They are saying, Shanu, you will always be the perfect size for these things. Dadi is saying, I'll always tell you stories. Dadu is saying, you can take me for my morning walks. Abbu is saying, I will lift you up on my shoulders. Her ammi is saying, you say you will always go to school. Then it means for these things you are perfect. You are not big enough and you are not small enough. At last, they give Shanu a warm and wonderful hug because her family love her so much. So students, I hope you all have understood the chapter, and let's recap once from starting. So tell me, who is Ammi? Shanu's mother. Who is Shanu? Shanu is a girl who is confused that is she big or is she small. Who is Abbu? Shanu's father. Who is Dadu? Shanu's grandfather. Who is Dadi? Shanu's grandmother. Okay? Who is puzzled? Shanu is puzzled. Why is Shanu puzzled? Because she doesn't know if she is too big or too small. So students, we have done with the chapter. I hope you all enjoyed the story of Shanu and her confusions about her size. We will learn some new words and their meaning in the next video. So, till then, goodbye. Take care of yourself. Bye. Good morning.